My question is, how does it feel to be here at the Apollo once again?
After 40 years of being here as the owner, how could I not feel nothing but very, very happy at this very moment? Yes. You know, and I'm glad that you were here to ask me that question.
And I'm happy to be here to ask you the question.
And I say thank you very much.
A story of redemption and resilience. Can we talk about a brother whose name was mentioned a little earlier, Dr. Guy Fisher. Yeah. Former business partner to one-time boss, Nicky Barnes. Here's an intriguing, rare story, and in many ways separates him from from his contemporaries. His redemption story is powerful and complicated in ways that we now define him as resilient. He's born and raised in the neighborhoods of the Bronx. Dr. Fisher chose to pursue an education and give his life and purpose a new meaning. And during his 38 years of incarceration, he mentored other inmates and inspired them to seek out education. So the now young man at 76 years young is the first state a federal inmate to earn 4 degrees. While he was incarcerated and has written several books and screenplays that I'm sure we're going to see soon, and he condemns his past criminal actions, would you please give a wonderful, thunderous Harlem Honors round of applause to Dr. Guy Fisher. He can't hear you, Dr. Guy Fisher.
First and foremost, I want to say thank you for being here, and I want to say thank you for everybody that is here. It has taken me over 40 years to get here, and I'm here. And I mean, my whole life, while has been a situation where I have had to serve time. Being here was a life that I had for this, for me, for my family, for my friends and loved ones. That's why I said, I want to say thank you to each and everybody that's sitting here, standing here, or being here, period, to let you know that. My thing now is, I refused to let life changed my life. I refused to be a bad guy. So what I did was I used education as a means in which to change my life. So with me, my thing is this. While I was incarcerated, my mother died. So it was one of those situations where I was sent to jail for a crime. I ain't even had nothing to do with that shit. I was so mad, it just got the best of me. But I didn't hate. I didn't allow hate to get the best of me. Because as a result of carrying hate, that shit is so heavy. If I was hating, oh my God. I was just, guys would say, hey, you know so-and-so? I said, man, I ain't with that. Y'all have to find out on your own. Because I didn't want to be a part of hatred, and I let it go. But now what I'm saying is that to the youth of America that's incarcerated, I was able to bring guys together. I ended up with 100 guys. I had them sign up for a class that I was in the joint with. And I said, dig this here, man. I said, it's an opportunity for each and every one of you sitting here to grant something that's positive, that's yours. Not hate, but something that'll make a difference so that you can help other people. So what happened was, it was 100 guys that became guys that wanted to be a part of the movies that I was writing and the things that I was writing. So a lot of guys said, man, I want to write something about drugs. I said, I'm not with that, man. Being here and making this joint my joint when I came home, it made a difference. And I made the name of this joint was Us. And when I say Us, each and everyone that's here, y'all know what I'm talking about. It was Us and Us alone. And that's how I went. And when they freed me, I said, man, the one thing about it is I can't wait to be a part of the youth of America's lives. My thing is to get the youth to get degrees. Certain individuals would come around and say, hey, Fisher, The warden told me to talk to you. And I told the warden, I said, warden, man, why would you be bringing people in here, man?
Let me say something.
My husband is so happy to be here that he's never going to let you go. Never. He will not leave the stage. It's been over 40 years that he attended this Apollo, and he's overwhelmed with feelings. And I really appreciate you guys, and I am going to forever take care of your king.
I just want to say thank you to everybody.
Oh, no. And thank you, Bunny and family.
Yes, most definitely.
Let's go. Stop.
Make some noise for Dr. Guy Fisher, huh? When the missus comes for you, it's a wrap.